Is the Creality SpacePi X4 the best overall filament dryer, especially for moisture-sensitive engineering materials such as polycarbonate, nylon, carbon-filled, and glass-filled, and others? That's what we're going to find out in this video. Hi, this is Ken of Wrist Innovations, and I may have found the best overall solution to getting rid of moisture from your high-temperature engineering filaments that can ruin your 3D prints. Let's talk about the Creality SpacePi X4 filament dryer, especially designed for high-temperature 3D printing filaments. I want to thank Creality for sending me their SpacePi X4 for my evaluation. Okay, let's get started. Let's talk features. Number one, the most important feature to me about the SpacePi X4 is that it has a maximum temperature of 85 degrees C, or 185 degrees F, using dual chambers that can each hold two spools of filaments. This is a higher temperature than most of the other filament dryers on the market, because most of the other filament dryers only have a maximum temperature of 70 degrees C. Number two, the X4 will dry your more common filaments such as ABS, ASA, and TPU, but it will also be able to dry your higher temperature filaments such as PC, PA6 glass filled and carbon filled, and PAHT CF that require drying temperatures of 80 degrees C. The only materials that it can't fully dry are PPACF and PPSCF that require drying temperatures of 100 degrees C or higher. Number three, the overall size of the X4 is 382 millimeters wide by 290 millimeters deep by 270 millimeters high, so it's a compact design. Number four, the X4 can fit four spools up to 200 millimeters in diameter by 150 millimeters wide. Two spools in two separate chambers, so you can dry up to four spools at the same time using different temperature settings and times for each chamber. Number five, the X4 drying time can be set from 1 to 48 hours. Number six, the X4 has rollers in the bottom that allow the spools to rotate freely, so you can leave the spools in the dryer and connect them directly to your printer to keep them in a dry environment while you are printing. Number seven, there are two fans, one for each chamber, that circulates the air 360 degrees around the spools, and the dual 200 watt heaters provide the heat source for each of the chambers. Number eight, each chamber has a small pocket that holds auto-regenerating desiccants that help control the humidity. The desiccants are regenerated during each drying cycle, so you don't need to replace them. Number nine, it has a nice 3.2 inch color LCD touchscreen that allows you to set the temperature and drying time in each of the dual chambers. It displays the actual temperature, set point temperature, relative humidity, and time. I especially like the visual aspects of the screen, showing the temperature changes over time. Number 10, the X4 has two dehumidification fans in the back, one for each chamber, that also have one-way check valves so they don't let humid air back into the chambers. Number 11, the X4 has four filament exit holes in the back, two for each chamber, that you can install PTFE tubing and connect directly to your printer to keep the filament from being exposed to your humid room conditions. Okay, so now let's dry some filaments. Parts test. I chose two moisture-sensitive materials to dry in the SpacePi X4. The first filament I tested was TPU. This is a very flexible material that is very sensitive to humidity. At the making of this video, July of 2025, we are in the middle of our high humidity time of the year in the northeast of the US, which can range from 60% to 90%. I set two spools of filament, a TPU spool and a PA6 CF spool, outside for several days. At one point, they were exposed to rain, so I would say that I exposed the filaments to excessive moisture. I brought the spools back into my shop and I used my 3D printed spool rewinder to wipe off the excess rain from the spools because I didn't want all the water to get inside my printer tubing. Next, I printed these death racer tracks using the TPU spool. The Death Racer tracks are part of the Death Racers project that is led by Sam Prentice of the Real Sam Prentice YouTube channel. You can see that there is excessive stringing, especially between the tracks. Then I place the same spool of TPU into the SpacePi X4 and I set the temperature for 60 degrees C for 8 hours. The X4 only took 10 minutes to reach the set temperature of 60 degrees C, and the humidity continued to drop from 47% to a final level of about 15%. After drying, I printed the same Death Racer tracks and the stringing was greatly reduced. So drying the TPU had a major positive impact on the quality of the parts. Next, PA6CF. Creality provided me with their PA6CF, which is nylon combined with carbon fibers. This filament has a high heat resistance and stiffness, so it's great for engineering applications. I printed this pipe wrench from 3dprintedhardware.com using the Creality PA6CF that I had exposed to the outside elements for several days. The wrench actually turned out better than I expected. However, it did have several defects. Then I placed the PA6CF into the X4 and I set the temperature to 80 degrees C for 8 hours. The X4 only took 20 minutes to reach the 80 degrees set point, and the humidity gradually dropped from 47% to 15% at 5 hours and remained at 15% for the balance of the 8-hour cycle. After drying, I printed the same pipe wrench, and there was definitely an improvement in the quality, especially with the inside threads of the adjustment nut. The parts all went together easily, and the pipe wrench works very smoothly. A couple of quick notes. Creality actually recommends to dry their particular filament at 85 degrees, but I didn't seem to have any problems even at 80 degrees with my test. The other thing I want to mention is I printed the second wrench using a 0.6 millimeter diameter nozzle because I was having some clogging problems with my 0.4 millimeter nozzle. I did one last test with an empty X4 to see how long it would take to reach the maximum temperature of 85 degrees C. It took only 15 minutes to reach the maximum 85 degrees C temperature. Now let's talk about pricing. I would like to interrupt this show for a special news report. Creality is having a special during the month of July. As of early July 2025, the Creality SpacePi X4 filament dryer is on sale for $159. Normally, it costs $199, so a $40 savings. This sale continues until July 30th. There is even a Prime Day special sale of the SpacePi X4 for $149 from July 8th through July 11th, saving you $50. So, if you are mainly printing PLA and PETG and occasionally printing some ABS or ASA, then you might want to consider a lower cost alternative such as the Creality SpacePi Plus filament dryer at a sale price of $89.99, normally $104.25. The SpacePi Plus can dry two spools at a time. However, the maximum temperature is limited to 70 degrees C. So it won't be able to dry the higher temperature engineering materials. But if you are not printing the higher temperature filaments, then the SpacePi Plus would be a good choice. If you are on a budget and you are only occasionally printing materials such as ABS or ASA, then Creality offers their original single spool SpacePi filament dryer, which is on sale at $65.99, normally $69.99. But if in fact you are printing higher temperature engineering materials such as PC, PA6, or PA12, glass-filled or carbon-filled, then the SpacePi X4 can really help you manage the quality of your prints by removing moisture from these moisture-sensitive materials. Now, back to your regularly scheduled show. Final summary. The SpacePi X4 is an effective filament dryer for most of the materials that you might use for your 3D printing needs, especially for the higher temperature moisture-sensitive materials such as PC, PA6, and PA12 carbon-filled and glass-filled. At a maximum drying temperature of 85 degrees C, it is one of the highest temperature filament dryers on the market. It has dual 200-watt heaters that heat up the two chambers to 60 degrees C in 10 minutes and 85 degrees C in 15 minutes. At a sale price of $159, it's a reasonable price to be able to dry 4 spools at a time of most of your materials you might use for your 3D printing needs. The only materials that it can't fully dry are PPA and PPS carbon filled, since they need at least 100 degrees C to dry them. If you want to see my video titled, "Do You Really Need a Filament Dryer for Your 3D Printing?" that link is here. If you want to see my video titled, "Which is the best brand of PLA filament for 3D printing?" that link is here. Thanks for watching. Bye!